On the political scene, one of the Democratic candidates is Senator Joseph Biden. Have you seen the problem he's been having? He went around and made a speech, and apparently he quoted a British politician, took his speech and kind of paraphrased it as his own. And then he was charged also with taking part of Bobby Kennedy's speeches. And Biden says, not to worry, he reassured his staff. He said, we have nothing to fear but fear itself.
Yes, the Democrat Party and plagiarism, they've been dancing together for a long, long time, haven't they? And now, Harvard University, the gay era comes to a screeching halt. The end of the gay era at Harvard University, such as it is, if you, well, semantically, I wouldn't want to. Well, happy hump day to you. Happy Wednesday. This is the day, it's a tradition in the Clinton household, that Hillary wakes up face down in a pool of her own dried vomit, knowing that her beloved and loving husband, Bill Clinton, has, a date coming over. It's someday, the Secret Service knows it. Every Wednesday, they know they got to go in early because Hillary is face down on the linoleum kitchen floor. Pool of her own dried vomit with an empty cardboard box of cheap New Zealand Chardonnay next to her. Ah, the Clintons. They're wonderful, aren't they? And the Obama. What do you think the Obamas are? We don't hear a lot from the Obamas. That's because they're preparing for their comeback, don't you think? When Michelle reluctantly accepts the nomination of her party after Joe Biden steps aside, probably fakes an illness. Remember when Joe Biden, he warned us, he gave us a heads up years ago that when things go sideways in his presidency, that he will fake an illness and he will step down. And I think that day may be approaching. Tick, tick, tick. Did you see Joe Biden arriving at the White House last night, getting off of the Marine One helicopter, HMX-1, great Marine Corps helicopter unit? And Joe Biden, they crank up the helicopter so you can't hear him. And hey, eh? And Festus was stumbling into the White House from the South Lawn, had a question or two, yelled at him, but he babbled, oh, damn Republicans won't let me secure the border. I need a lot more money. He always said, how many trillions and trillions? You know that Joe Biden has added $6 trillion to the national debt in under 3 years, less than 3 years, $6 trillion to the national debt. And Democrats keep going around saying, oh, well, but all the bridges and roads. Yeah, right. Yeah. Actually, states pay for bridges and roads. But never mind that. You can set that aside because facts don't matter with the Democrat Party. They, at least, are living in a post-fact era. And now Harvard is living in a post-gay era. How do you think that'll affect the student body can you still major in I hate Jews? Is that, because that is a, I think, did you see that she's staying, Claudine Gay? She's staying. She's not leaving Harvard University. She just has to change offices. But she will continue to make more than $900,000 a year for being a Harvard professor of you're a racist. That's what she teaches. She teaches in the, you can get a degree and everybody else is a racist, but not me at Harvard University. And that's what she teaches. And she's not a scholar by any stretch of the imagination, but they selected her because of identity politics to become the first black woman president of Harvard. And that was really good enough. Scholarship, not so important. Intellect, not so important, but, you know, she checked some boxes. And is she LGBTQ, Michael? As I understand it, she is not, but her name is gay, which helps. That's got to be worth half points, I think. You don't get the full box check on that, but you get half points for being named gay and a black woman. And what she scribbled 11 papers together or something like that. And she plagiarized, like Joe Biden, who... that was Johnny Carson, of course, for those who don't remember. That's kind of a Joe Biden joke on a number of levels because Joe Biden has been around so long. Let's go to the, you know, what do we have? That was the Johnny Carson joke about Joe Biden when he was running for president. Now let's go to Jack Parr making fun of, now let's go to Jack Benny making fun of Joe Biden not so early in his political career. Extra. Now, here's Groucho Marx making fun of Joe Biden because Joe Biden is, you know, I got to tell you, I know people Joe Biden's age that can fly fighter jets and play golf at the same time. Joe Biden can't walk across the lawn by himself. You see his wife last night, not a Dr. Jill Biden, kind of yelling at him and waving him into the White House. Hurry up, stop talking, don't say anything. You're going to say something dumb. Because she knows she's the one that let him run for president in the first place. That was not a good idea. That was a bad idea. She should probably be charged with crimes. Isn't that what happens now? Everybody, all your political adversaries are charged with crimes because, you know, banana republic, because the left is here. Michael, for how many years have I been saying this? The left is the third world, right? If the left takes over your country is a third world country. That's the most important element in having a third world country, is having a left-wing regime in charge. And the Democrat Party is a left-wing party. They are in charge, and the White House and the Senate and the bureaucracy across the federal bureaucracy, and they've also dug in deep across the federal bureaucracy insidiously, and they're having their way with our country, like they're having their way with academia and the Poison Ivy League and all of that. But, so many things. The Democrats, how much stuff have the Democrats given us today? Too much stuff, I think. And speaking of third world countries, do you see, there was a guy arrested at the Capitol recently with a machete and a giant butcher knife. And I know you're thinking, third world banana republic, chop, chop, like MS-13. They like to chop teenagers to death with machetes, which they've done around Washington, D.C. many times. And the Democrats don't care. They honestly don't care. Just like they don't care about the nice 18-year-old girl that was murdered a block from this radio station an hour and 20 minutes after New Year's Eve a couple of nights ago. Nice 18-year-old girl. What, she was the president of her high school class, right? And she's at LSU, Louisiana State, and she's doing great. And her grandfather is a pastor, a reverend, and a Democrat kid. The problem is not our guns, it's your sons. And then a young man, 18 years old, with a handgun went into their hotel room party and shot this lovely, and you see pictures of her smiling, looks like a wonderful person, and loved by her grandfather, the pastor, doing great at LSU, president of her class in high school, and shot to death, the first homicide of 2024 in Washington, D.C., but we're only 61 square miles, and had last year's homicide, the number of homicides, the greatest number of homicides in 26 years, more than a quarter of a century, and the local media yawns, the Washington Post yawns, the Democrats yawn, but I repeat myself, just extraordinary, the guy caught with the machete and the butcher knife at the Capitol, he's an illegal alien. He's an illegal alien that was caught with his machete at the Capitol. He didn't have the opportunity to chop anyone to death. Where's he from, Michael? He's an illegal alien from Venezuela, which is a socialist paradise that the Democrats are promising for us here in the United States. And always keep in mind, as Vladimir Lenin said, the goal of socialism is communism. And they know that. They definitely know that. So we got that going on. And just extraordinary, extraordinary stuff. The Democrat Party. The illegal alien with the machete and the butcher knife was arrested in 2022 under Joe Biden's regime and released by Customs and Border Protection in 2022. Now, in 2023, days ago, charged with carrying dangerous weapon and possession of prohibited weapons, right? No big deal. He crossed illegally into the United States at El Paso, Texas, and the Democrats waved him in and gave him a gift basket. They might have given him the machete, too, so he can chop teenage girls to death, as MS-13 likes to do and so on. And now in 2024, he's facing removal proceedings. So we'll, in theory, throw him out of the country, but with an open border, he can just walk back in because the Democrats want everybody murdered. They just want a third world country. It's truly extraordinary what the Democrats have done to this country in such a short period of time. Joe Biden has not been president for 3 years yet. not quite 3 years. January 20th will mark 3 years, the three-year anniversary of Joe Biden becoming the president of the United States. And the damage that they have done with Barack Obama behind the curtain and Michelle Obama hates you. She put out a Christmas message. It was short. I hate all of you. It was a Michelle Obama Christmas message to America. She didn't really. I made that up. But it's what she feels. It's amazing stuff. And we've got amazing stuff. Senator Bob Menendez, they call him Bob. Senator Robert Menendez, who's a corrupt Democrat, has got another. He's already been charged with bribery and extortion. Just bribery and extortion, no big deal. Honest services fraud. I think all politicians are guilty of honest services fraud, probably. But now we've got a new story on Senator Menendez because he's got another country that is giving him stuff, you know, money and things worth money, because he's corrupt. And he also had that sexual issue in the Dominican Republic a few years ago, didn't he, with underage prostitutes? And that story just goes away when you're a Democrat because the news media is that corrupt. And members of the news media, they hope that their daughters grow up to be male prostitutes. Fred Garvin, male prostitute. Just amazing stuff. That's just scratching the surface on a few things to get to today. Harvard president's resignation fuels accusation of racism from black leaders. They actually call Al Sharpton a black leader. That is a huge problem for black people in the United States of America. That and homicide. You know, that's two big problems. Al Sharpton and homicide. But Claudine Gay, in spite of the fact that the racists at Harvard, and it's called the Harvard Corporation, that they're the boardroom people at Harvard University, they're the ones that decided that she had to go, but she doesn't really go. She stays at Harvard. She's going to continue to make at least $900,000 a year to teach racism and anti-Semitism at Harvard. Don't ever hire anyone that graduated from Harvard. I mean, I don't care if you've got your business is brake linings or investment. Don't hire anyone from Harvard. You got nothing but trouble in front of you if you hire anyone from Harvard. And Congresswoman Elise Stefanik, Republican New York, she deserves almost all of the credit for what happened. And this is about something much bigger than Claudine Gay and the end of the gay era at Harvard and the idiot president at a University of Pennsylvania resigning too. It's about much more than that. It's about the left corrupting everything. The racist left corrupting everything. You know, Harvard University is the racist university that discriminates against Asian students because they are white adjacent. Asian students and families are white adjacent. That's what the left calls Asian people because that makes them feel better about discriminating against Asian people. They're fine with discriminating against white people. We are talking about taking away their electricity. You should just know that. And rights to fly on airplanes and use global instantaneous communications and modern medicine. We're talking about taking those things away. But never mind that. Just extraordinary stuff. They discriminate against Asians. And then they have the From the River to the Sea, Kill the Jews movement. And everything's a movement with these people, right? It might be because they're constipated and they need some kind of movement in their lives. But amazing stuff. And she is complaining that it is, you know, it's a she was brought down by a mob, she says, and it's racial animus. Just madness. But this is about the bigger picture in the United States of America. The left is like, oh, the right's waging culture war. Yeah, stop looting my neighborhood. Stop shooting people. Secure our border. Let's try to have an economy, a Western-style economy. How about that? Yeah, and what does she teach? What is Claudine Gay? I read they still have her page up at the Harvard website. I photographed it because I know they're going to change it today. And then there's the plagiarism, more than 50 counts of plagiarism, just like Joe Biden. And Johnny Carson making fun of Joe. Was that the 1970s?
80s.
Yeah, it was the 80s. making fun of Joe Biden for his plagiarism. And the media is very angry. Oh, those right-wingers and their culture wars. That's because they're all racists. That's the thing about them. The machete-wielding illegal alien from Venezuela. He's going to get a gift basket on the way out the door, and he'll turn around and walk right back in because machete-wielding lunatics are just Democrat Party voters, the way the DNC sees it. Amazing stuff. Nice young lady murdered by a Democrat. She had a brilliant future, and nobody cares. You know, Black Lives Matter. Remember the Black Lives Matter thing? They chanted they burned cities because of that. And they're still looting, the Democrats are, because of all that. But in reality, you know, a lovely, well-raised 18-year-old African-American girl going to college, murdered for nothing minutes after midnight at a party, and nobody bats an eye. Because the Democrat Party lies a lot. Jeffrey Epstein, you got Jeffrey Epstein. Beware, because the list, you know, that's good stuff. Beware, it might snow this weekend. Remember, it's never too early to panic. Never too early to panic. We got a whole bunch of crazy for you because the Democrats are still on the loose. We are at 888-630-9625. Hey, it's Chris Plant, excited to tell you about our July 2024 Listener Sea Cruise. We'll be sailing around the British Isles, visiting Scotland and Ireland. Please join us. Visit chrisplantcruise.com. All right, we are back. Today is Wednesday. It's mailbag day. It's not only waking up in a pool of your own dried vomit day for Hillary Clinton, it's also mailbag day. Those are unrelated. But got that, and Democrats causing absolute mayhem everywhere because, remember, the Democratic Party isn't. All right, let's go to the phones. Let's go to Ivan, calling from Miramar Beach, Florida. Ivan, you're on the Chris Plant Show.
Hey, Chris, good morning. How you doing, man?
Very well.
Hey, happy New Year, man. Hey, listen, I thought you'd get a real big kick out of this. You remember when Charlamagne, the God, the radio black radio host, he interviewed Joe Biden? And Biden infamously said to Charlamagne, he said, if you don't support me, you ain't black.
Oh, yes.
You remember that?
Oh, yes.
Well, evidently, Charlamagne, the guy, just recently rescinded his support for Joe and Kamala. So, evidently, Charlamagne the God ain't black after all.
This is getting more and more complicated, this whole racial thing. In fact, I think we played it yesterday. We played that, here's Joe Biden, you ain't black.
But I tell you, if you have a problem figuring out whether you're for me or Trump, then you ain't black.
That's right, then you ain't black, right, Ivan? That's it. That's your Democrat Party. Keeping in mind the party of the Confederacy and the KKK and Jim Crow, and they carry on the traditions to this day. Charlemagne the misspelled God. He misspelled the. I was typing his name into the computer. I accidentally spelled the correctly. Yeah, Charlemagne the misspelled God is an African-American radio show host, and the left loves him. He's black. Did I mention that he's black? Because the left loves him. They don't care about murder or abortion rates or incarceration rates. Well, they want to free all the criminals to vote Democrat, but that's another thing altogether. The radical left-wing extremists at the left-wing blog in Washington, D.C. called Politico did an interview with Charlemagne the misspelled God. He literally spells his it. First of all, he's Charlemagne. Okay, and then the THA God. An interesting demonstration of ego issues there, and misspelling. I love the left loves to deliberately misspell words because they're trying to create an illiterate society in our schools and at Harvard, and by just casually misspelling things, you know, movie titles and things. And it's keeping it real, you know, in the black thing. It's misspell it on purpose because that's rebellion or something like that. But Charlemagne, T-H-A, God. And I kid you not, when I saw Ivan calling from Florida, from Miramar Beach, wanted to say something about Charlemagne the God. I'm aware of the story from yesterday, Charlemagne the God. taking shots at Kamala Harris and stuff. And I went to write his name into the computer just to call up the story. And I made the mistake of writing T-H-E instead of T-H-A. Because, and I've always called him for many years now, Charlamagne, the misspelled God. Because if you're misspelling the, I don't think you're being helpful to anyone. Am I right about that? Darn tootin'. So the left-wing radicals at Politico, they typed up a piece on Charlamagne, the misspelled God. And the headline is, Trouble with the, T-H-A, God, G-O-D, interestingly enough. The influential radio host of The Breakfast Club, a name stolen from a John Hughes high school comedy from 1985, I think. The influential radio host of The Breakfast Club is a thorn in the side of Democrats. No, he's not. He's always fluffed the Democrats, and he supported Joe Biden. And yeah, Joe, and if you don't vote for me, if you don't support me, you're not black. That was from Charlamagne, the misspelled God's radio show, right, where Joe Biden was on there. He's not a thorn in their side. He's another useful idiot for the global left peddling the lies that the left likes to peddle. But he's also representative of one of their biggest problems. He's representative of one of their biggest problems. And Brecton Booker typed the story on behalf of the global left. The dateline is New York. It's not so much that Charlemagne, the misspelled God, has beef with the president. Now, it said, and this is what it says. It doesn't say a beef. It says this is the first sentence of the story written by Brecton Booker and published, and it made all kinds of news, by the left-wing Politico. It's not so much that Charlemagne, the, T-H-A, God, has beef with the president. I believe, you know, sentence number one, do you have editors there? Do you have you ever read anything? It has a beef. He's got beef with, that's, so we got, we're misspelling the, and then we have an illiterate sentence to open the story. It's just that he thinks Joe Biden is a lousy messenger. Yeah, right. They said, and that he lacks the basic political skills that, whatever one thinks about the guy, Donald Trump possesses. See, you can't say that. Now he's in danger. Sitting in the second row of his black Escalade, the second row, it's like a theater-sized Escalade, the second row of his black Escalade as his driver, he's got a driver, crawls through Manhattan traffic on a late October morning. Took a long time to pull this story together, huh? Because the dateline is yesterday, or the timestamp is yesterday. The co-host of the influential Breakfast Club radio show said Biden and others in his circle spend too much time posturing. You think? Hey, this is why, you know, he makes $10 million a year, because he sees that the Democrats spend a lot of time posturing. That's kind of hard to believe, right?
What's something that you always carry with you?
Hot sauce.
Really?
Really?
Are you getting information right now? Hot sauce. Hot sauce in my bag, Swag?
Hot sauce.
Really?
Hot sauce.
Yes.
Now listen, I just want you to know, people are going to see this and say, okay, she's pandering to black people.
Okay. Is it working?
That's the Charlamagne, the misspelled God radio show with Hillary, Diane, Rodham, Clinton claiming falsely that she always carries hot sauce. Is it working? People are going to say you're pandering to black people, because all black people, as we know, carry hot sauce in their purses. And I've got hot sauce right in front of me on the desk, little miniature Tabasco sauce thing from an MRE, you know, Meals Ready to Eat. All of the, that's it. It's amazing. So the left-wing radicals at Politico continue. It's almost like Democrats are doing this purity test, says Charlamagne the God. America is not pure. Yeah, but the Democrat Party is sure that the people of America are not pure. We're flawed, he says. Oh, I see. Flawed is the standard. Now, you're pure, Charlamagne the misspelled God. Pure what? I can't say on the radio because of FCC rules, but I'm not looking for my politicians to be pure. I'm looking for my politicians to be effective, effective at what is the question. That's kind of an important question. So this is a fluffer story, and it goes on and on. That's why, you know, they did the interview in October, and it didn't get published until January, but never mind that. Let's see, October, November, December, January. Is it like 300 pages long? No, it's not. It's amazing. This is just such the Democrat Party. And this guy, Charlamagne, the misspelled God. And the Hillary with the pandering and the sucking of the black people. Now, did anybody in the room say, let's see your hot sauce? No, they didn't. So they just let that go. Oh, they're going to say you're pandering. Is it working? Yeah. And then Charlamagne the misspelled God on Joe Biden. He had Joe Biden on there, and Joe Biden said these ridiculous and outrageous things. And Charlamagne the misspelled God says all kinds of ridiculous things as well, because he's a leftist.
Biden's not getting any younger. He's not going to get any more popular, and he's not getting a new running mate. So please, Mr. President, give America the ultimate Christmas gift and step aside.
This is on The Daily Show. Is that still on the air? Didn't John Stewart guy, he passed from old age or something? Hasn't he moved on to his great reward? And amazing. And that was December 8th. Now, I've been suggesting Joe Biden should step aside for quite a long time, long before December 8th. And I still predict that he will step aside. But never mind all that. And so Charlamagne, the misspelled God, is with his giant radio contract and all that said, he's just unbelievable. So he said, in 2024, it's a race between the cowards, the crooks, and the couch, he said, referring to Biden, the cowards, Trump, the crooks. Yeah, right. I'm sorry. How many millions of dollars did the Biden family take from Ukraine, from Romania, from Kazakhstan, I think, from China, from Moscow, from Russia, Putin's Russia, millions of dollars. How many fake companies did they set up to move money around? How many suspicious activity reports? I think more than 120, maybe more than 150 from the Treasury Department. You got your crooks living in the White House right now. But, you know, he's a Democrat, so he's uninformed. And when he becomes informed, then he's misinformed. That's an old one. You know, who was that? Mark Twain? Is that if you don't read the news, if you don't read the news, you're uninformed. If you do read the news, you're misinformed. It continues to be true to this day. In 2024, it's a race between the cowards, that's the Democrats, the crooks, that's the Republicans, and the couch, and that's staying home. And this is what passes for genius in our culture these days. Honestly, we should set the bar a lot higher. Just amazing stuff. Charlemagne suspects the couch will win. He says the couch will win because that means people will stay home and they will not vote. The left is mentally ill. Can I just say that? Just grow up. Try growing up. How old is Charlemagne the God? He's over 21. He's old enough to know better. And I'm embarrassed for everybody in our country. And our media landscape is a disgrace to Western civilization. And all that Western civilization has accomplished, just extraordinary stuff. But this is now a big deal because Charlamagne the misspelled God he's an influencer. He doesn't even need to go on, whatever and post videos. He's an influencer. And the Fox News headline, Charlamagne the misspelled God regrets backing Kamala Harris for VP. For VP, regrets backing Kamala Harris. And the Daily Wire, Charlamagne, the misspelled God, taps out, after Kamala Harris, quote, kind of disappeared. So now he's attacking, and how unaware can you be and still be a major media figure in the United States, America? The answer is very. You can be very unaware. And here he is, that Kamala kind of disappeared. Now, that's not really up to her. She's the vice president. She's not the number one. She's the number two, okay? And prominent black radio host. And I love that it's, do they, like if they write a story about me, do they say, prominent and excellent and talented white radio show host? And Don't you think they should? I think they should, since they're racists about everything. A prominent black radio show personality reportedly feels burned over the past his past support of Vice President Kamala Harris. What are you doing supporting a vice president? Nobody supports a vice president. Charlamagne, the misspelled god, the co-host of The Breakfast Club, stolen from John Hughes' movie, who was born Leonard Larry McKelvey. Hey, Lair. Hey, Lair, Lair. Larry, Leonard Larry McKelvey. You think you should go with Lenny or Larry? What do you think? Spoke to Politico about his break with Harris after her nearly 3 years in the White House. Well, kind of in the White House. I learned my lesson from doing that, said Lenny, and to Politico. Once they got in the White House, she kind of disappeared. I assume that's Politico providing the right? because when you're speaking to someone, Joe Biden does. He says, because when they put an ellipsis in the teleprompter, he reads it out loud. they think, the writers of his speeches think that, you know, this means he'll take a breath, he'll pause, but not Joe Biden.
Period. Period. Period.
No, sorry, Mr. President, that was an ellipsis. You were just supposed to pause for a moment there. Charlamagne reportedly explains that he does not think the Biden administration has done enough to tackle mental health awareness. That seems pretty clear. A topic that came up as he appeared on the campaign trail with Harris in 2019 when she was a presidential candidate. That didn't last very long. That was a one-day thing. She dropped out before the first the first primary because everyone recognized this person is not seriously running for president, is she? I mean, come on. And promote criminal justice reforms that include addressing marijuana offenses. Everybody just wants to be stoned all the time, and they don't want to go to jail for their crimes.
Have you ever smoked?
I have.
Okay.
Like I inhale. I did inhale. It was a long time ago. But yeah.
3 days.
I just broke loose.
She just broke loose. Ooh, wow, breaking loose, smoking pot. Wow, that's really wild. Out there on the edge, isn't it? And Charlamagne the misspelled god said, when I give people my word, like yo man, I think we should be supporting Kamala Harris for vice president because she's going to hold it down. She's going to hold it down. That could be illegal, holding it down. When we say those things and people don't see her holding it down, that causes issues. Right. I feel like I'm keeping it real even just reading this out loud, don't you? Charlamagne the misspelled god added, damn, you told us to vote for them. Do you know how many people say that to me all the time? See, Charlamagne told people to vote for them, for Joe Biden, and then people said, I don't know how I'm going to vote. I'm going to wait until Charlamagne the misspelled god tells me how to vote. And then I'm going to vote for Harris and for Biden. But, you know, Biden's an old white guy, so I don't know what they're going to do about that. So this is called journalism today. And this is politics. This is the Democrat Party politics, right? Charlamagne quipped, I can't tell sometimes, he says. After which Harris shot back, no, she said. No, it's Joe Biden. And don't just start talking like a Republican about asking whether or not he's president and it's Joe Biden. And I'm vice president and my name is Kamala Harris. This is the interview. This is our government. You wonder why everything is going to hell? This is kind of it in a nutshell right here. We have unserious, unintelligent people that are ruling the United States. And that's the way they view it. They're not governing. They don't have, you know, government taxpayer-funded jobs. They're not serving the American people. They're ruling. They're radicals. They're just crazy. Politico noted that Charlamagne the misspelled god does not expect Harris or President Biden to be on The Breakfast Club during the current election cycle. They used him and threw him away last time. They lied to him. The usual stuff. It's like being a Bill Clinton date in which they're seeking a second term amid poor approval numbers and dropping support among black voters. Maybe they should pander more. Maybe they should get a larger bottle of hot sauce. That ought to do it. Maybe people should vote based on something other than hot sauce and pandering. Just saying, you know. There are more important things in the world, I think. I might be a little old-fashioned, though. We're at 888-630-9625. More crazy Democrat hijinks coming up. For example, the Portland, or, you know, Portland used to be a great city. Democrats got a hold of it. Portland poop crisis. They've got a poop crisis. Triggers bacterial outbreak normally found in third world. I've got that coming up because the Democrats are fixing things. They're making everything better. Yes, sir. And Jimmy Kimmel. Jimmy Kimmel versus Aaron Rodgers, the NFL quarterback. Jimmy Kimmel hosts a game show, right? Is it a game show? And I got that coming up, too. Wacky Democrats. I was just reading about the illiteracy crisis in America, in schools and across America, as Charlamagne the Misspelled God has beef with the president, according to Politico. I think you guys are contributing to the illiteracy crisis. Let's take a quick phone call. Let's go to Richard, calling from Columbia, Maryland. Richard, you're on the Chris Plant Show.
Oh, yeah. Hi. I was just at the pharmacy here. So I've noticed something in the last, I mean, we've been hearing about this, and you talked about it yourself, the last 100, 200 years, how they, the Democrats, have held back the African-American community with Jim Crow, slavery, you name it. Imagine what could happen if they were allowed the freedom to decide how they want to live. Like, should they get a COVID vaccine? Should they, you know, instead of being on welfare all the time, they can get a job they want and based on their merit.
Yeah, trapped in schools that don't serve their children well. They complain about the school-to-prison pipeline that the Democrats created, by the way. And Joe Biden was a major contributor to that. This is about information dominance, Richard. The left has secured information dominance and, to a large extent, cultural dominance in the United States, and they're using it to destroy.